aspirations. If you sit down and stay in shape, you'll still have pro aspirations because you don't forget how to play football. I've been playing football for, at this point, 16, 17 years. I'm good. I ain't forget nothing. I ain't forgot nothing.
Do you think they'll change their mind? Since they got those signatures, and a lot of the alumni want them to have another meeting to reconsider.
They are going to change. This whole red herring, so to speak, was to get people, to get the public at large on board. Either fire the brother or get the public at large on board. Period.
Oh, man. Well, one of the NCAA doctors pretty much basically said a couple of days ago that this sport's not safe.
That man said...
Exactly, the NCAA chief medical officer said that.
Right.
He said if the testing stay the way that it is, there's no way they can move forward with sports. And he said that to CNN.
Yeah, he said this is literally like playing Russian roulette. And no, only people like Booker McFarland, he spoke up. He said, nah, man, because ain't nobody going to be looking out for these kids in 10 years when they got all these problems. But I play, and I will sue the... See, that's why my man in the Big Ten and Scott in the Big 12, I mean, Pac-12 said... We ain't going because they know one of these kids is going to get sick. And he might not get sick in 2020. He might not get sick until 2025. And his family is coming after their ass. Let's just be honest.
But just think about the hypocrisy in this, though, man. You have these people, these kids that still enrolled in these classes that they can't get sick, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right, now... They can't play sports. So shouldn't they shut down these institutions as well as far as not having them on campus?
It would make sense to me.
I mean, shit, my brother's going to spread the shit that way too.
Yeah. Then they show, I'm assuming you didn't see the picture. Somebody from Alabama posted a picture of the Alabama people walking around without masks on. The regular students walking around boo-booed out. They out there daring, they daring COVID to get their ass.
Yeah, well, if you got some motherfuckers that not believe in the shit, so it's a tug of war of people that want that's being shown facts, and it's people that just in it for the money, man. I mean, it's a tug of war. It's a battle to see who gonna win, but I don't want to be the motherfucker that catch this shit, so.
Yeah. And that's the thing, man.
They did a survey at my job to see if we wanted to go back to work. It's supposed to be anonymous. I damn near put my name on it.
Right. I don't get it, man. How could you vote to sit around a bunch of strangers? And how many times have we walked out of bathrooms and looked at some clown walk up out of there like the sink had a pile of crap on it? Ain't washed nothing.
That ain't washing hands.
Right. But these the people I'm going to trust to sit at a desk in a lecture hall. Y'all sound crazy. It's Richard Speck with this nonsense, man. What? And then you get these stupid-ass women talking about, our kids have worked their entire life. Okay, when you burying this motherfucking ass, then what? But I'm telling you, you notice University of Maryland ain't saying nothing. You know what? I ain't saying nothing.
Why not?
Because remember, that boy died on the Maryland campus from heat stroke a couple years ago. University of Maryland, like, look, my name Paul. That shit between y'all.
Then they family
student training staff. Yep. You see, they ain't trying to do it no more. Because University of Maryland said, nah, we learned our lesson. We learned our damn lesson. They ain't trying to hit none of that, man. Ain't none of them trying, man. And I don't care what nobody say. You can get Donald Trump to call in on the show. He called my number. And I'll tell him, you don't get a damn about nobody, but you trying to get reelected. Anybody who's...
I'm not going to call you unless you give me that big donation, man.
Right. Yeah, you got that shit. Right. He's
calling nobody. Or they giving these people money to make these videos. But anyway, that's not sports related. That's something else.
This our show, man. We're talking about fucking...
Yeah, man.
But... It's bananas, man. I just don't get it, bruh. I really don't understand. I'm like MC Light. I cram to understand how you willing to take the you know. And what's these folks' number one mantra? It's about the kids. It's about the kids. But you're going to put these kids. You're going to put our kids out there, though.
Yeah, but we'll see within the next maybe week and a half or 2 weeks.
Yeah, man. They're
gonna be
shooting up. And look, check this out. On another note, just to show you that America is doing this ass backwards. The CFL said, nah, we ain't playing.
Toronto kicked the motherfucking Blue Jays out. Right. Y'all ain't gonna be bringing
that
crap over here.
This just show you, man, how little people in America, how intelligent we are, man, as a country. It just shows you just how intelligent we are as a country, or the lack thereof intelligence that we have as a country. Because, man, how you put a whole nation in jeopardy? How in the hell do you put an entire nation in jeopardy for the entertainment of the nation?
How do that machine ain't working?
I bet you one of those ladies that signed that petition and say get back, I bet you she anti-abortion. I bet you some of those ladies anti-abortion. They will run that neck all day long. But we ain't with the abortion. But you want to abort somebody after they get here. But it's gonna take. And man, I hope like hell don't nobody get hurt from this. But one of these young men gonna get hurt, man. One of these young men gonna be permanently damaged. And then what?
We didn't see the signs that it was an infection. Cause you got motherfuckers like that, some baseball player from the Red Sox. He had the COVID, and now he having heart complications.
No, he got a heart condition. You're eating hog maws and chitlins.
Ice Cube.
Yeah, man. You asked me the question, what do you think about the Big Ten? You think they're going to go back? You think they're going to change their mind? You think they're going to shift gears?
No, I don't think so. Because pretty much once they said that, they kind of let the networks know and their sponsors know that, man, this shit ain't going on. So, I mean, it's easy for them to actually get that back on because what type of programming is ESPN going to have doing Saturdays? Because it's a law or something that the NFL can't play on Saturdays when it's college football being played or supposedly being played, right?
Yeah, it's an agreement. It's a gentleman's agreement. Because now the NFL talking about playing on Friday nights.
Yeah, I don't think that'd be a good night.
Hey, man. Pimping ain't easy, but somebody got to do it.
Actually, you know what? Well, if the bars were still open. Well, actually, all bars are still open.
Right.
So, actually, that wouldn't be a bad thing, though. No, I wouldn't go to the bar to watch this movie still.
The goofies will. Yeah, the goofballs will.
Yeah, that shit in the backyard.
Right. But that's the thing, man. It's just stupid, man.
Yeah, man. Well, I mean, unless they find a bubble situation for all these teams, but I don't see that happening.
Right. It's over 100 Division I or FBS schools. You can't find them.
Imagine telling a college. A teenager with all that you did around. Hey, man, I need you to stay in your dorm.
Yeah, because that's what Nick Saban, that's the lie Nick Saban run around the country telling. Mm-hmm. We just gonna ask them to stay in their rooms. For free? You want me to stay in my room for free? And,
my buddy tried to sneak on Grail in the Seahawks.
Right, he getting paid.
Jersey, uniform.
Yeah, hey, we're going to talk about that in a minute. We're going to talk about that goofball in a minute. What a dummy, man. He got
a... I'll be like, hey, man, they came to clean the dorm.
Yeah, they'll...
You need two of them? Yeah, they work better together.
Right. One gonna clean the carpet, the other gonna clean the bed. And then I saw a picture.
Hey, how long went in your room? Shit, let me see, what did I drink yesterday? I think it was in for about an hour.
Right. it's a sad commentary, bro. It is a sad commentary. Do you, before we even get into that whole get down. The last thing I want to talk about in this thing is, like I said, Justin Fields and all those dudes need to be asking for pay. What do you think it would take for these dudes to get paid, and how would you pay them?
I don't know what that is. Whoever sit down and have to do that, that's gonna be a hard job because you're not paying like this. Justin Fields is one of the leading Heisman candidates. You're not gonna pay him the same as you'll pay. I'm trying to remember the running back name for. Illinois, it's already E, but you're not gonna pay him the same that you would pay the running back for Illinois. You see what I'm saying?
Right. Hold it, but why not?
Justin Fields, because with Justin Fields, jersey, for instance, is gonna sell more than this person from this running back from Illinois. It's just like if you was back when the Fab Five was real popular, Nike and whoever was making their uniforms at the time was making a killer. You're not gonna pay Northwestern players more than you paying the Fab Five. At least I wouldn't go for that if I was the Fab Five.
Okay, with that being said, how about you pay in accordance to year?
If
you're a freshman, you make $25,000 a year. If you're a sophomore, you make $30,000 a year. If you're a junior, you make $40,000 a year. If you're a senior, you make $50,000. Or I'm just throwing those numbers out there.
I can see that.